So I suppose what I want to ask to begin with is about these characters. How do you do it? And I know that part of the answer, which you won't give, has to do with generosity of spirit and compassion, and you won't say that, so I will. But what else?
I've been asked regarding writing Aura. Aura is the main character in my novel. She's a woman at around 50, more or less. She lives separately from her husband. She has two boys. I really started to understand her when I just surrendered to her. And maybe this is the best thing that we can do as writers. We write about characters who are totally different from us. Sometimes they are contrary to us. I wrote about Palestinians. I wrote in Sea Under Love, there is a commander of an extermination camp. And I learned that within me there are so many options, in every one of us, so many options. And usually we put so much effort in remaining oneself, you know. But by so doing, we are so entrenched in one story life, one option of ourselves. And when I surrendered to Aura, suddenly I was able to become her.
Leading up to that, I never know where my books are going to go, ever. And I don't know from the outset, and I don't know for a very long time during the writing process. And this uncertainty, this very willful uncertainty that I hold myself to, is what allows for the discovery and what allows for, yes, to the opportunity to become another life, to go to places that I don't know, to make a discovery. For example, in this book, I chose characters who didn't make the same choices as I did. I wrote this book, I began this book not long, 18 months or so after my first son, Sasha, who you know, was born. And he was everything in my mind, in my life. And I finished this book here at the library and in the rocking chair while Sai was, you know, between naps of my youngest child. So my children, dedicated to my children, are everywhere in the conception of the book.
I don't know if you experienced it in your life yourself or you saw people, and it starts with one tick, and then the magic of these ticks, the temptation to organize your life or to cut your life in a certain order, and the life is being cut by this tick or the other tick, and you touch the joints here and the knees and the elbows, and suddenly you understand the attraction in it. You cannot reject this attraction. As a mother, Aura witnesses her son being swept into all this bureaucracy of the body and bureaucracy of the manners, and she doesn't know how to pull him back.
They do, of course, they take on a life of their own. Their language, which slowly develops, begin to dictate who they are. I do hear them speaking sometimes, the way that they speak. They are mysteries to me, and I feel I have to uncover their psychology, and eventually their psychology tells me what would happen next.
To put it into words, maybe it will make it more understandable or bearable for me. Because when something like that happens to you, you get to know so much more about life. I mean, so much is being revealed that I was not aware of before. Once death is so present and so predominant, life suddenly gets another dimension, so to say.